notice anything. Are you?
Mm-hmm.
No ring.
You actually need a ring for?
I do. We're engaged. It's romantic.
This is romantic. In bed, middle of the day.
Yeah. What's the time?
I don't know, I'm not too old.
Daniel.
Mm-hmm.
You've got things to do.
What things?
Arrangements.
I told you the engagement party is sorted.
And the wedding?
Small, we said.
Yeah, but I still need a dress and you still need a best man. Mm. I've got magazines, I just need help choosing.
Jamie, am I main about?
Yeah.
I'm sure Chrissy can help, or Pauline.
You know, I remember walking past this door. I speak. Where I joined 20 years ago. I looked in and Mum was sitting on the bed, you know, bedding around. She'd been crying. She was so alone, it scared me.
I'm not him.
You think us being married, do you think it'll change things?
It's gonna make it better.
Yeah.
You can trust me, Sharon. You can tell me anything. You're never going to be alone again.
It is.
Then why are you even thinking about it?
Because it's just a ring. I haven't got one, remember?
Ah, now you have. I got it down the market, just as promised. $12.99. Genuine fake.
Oh, it's lovely.
Well, it's just a joke.
No, I love it.
We don't need anything from him. We don't need him at this wedding. We don't ever need to see him again.
I know.
Come here. We just get out of here, we go and see Vicky.
He's dead, Dennis. That was Dad's body they took out of here, not someone who had nothing to do with us. You want to run away from this?
I just don't want him still ruining everything for us. It's happened, okay? We move on.
You know, I'm hanging on by a thread and all you want to do is act like it's nothing to do with you.
Of course it's to do with me, but he's dead. What do you want me to do, start crying?
Why not?
It's not the same for me.
I know you're not this cold, darling. I know I didn't marry a man who can't show his feelings.
He tried to destroy us. Am I supposed to just forget that? Am I supposed to forget that he slept with Zoe just to keep us apart?
He still didn't deserve what happened. You're glad he's dead, aren't you? This is exactly what you wanted, isn't it?
No, but then tried to drive a wedge between us. He manipulated you and me and everyone else to get what he wanted.
Wanted him
and
dead.
He's still doing it now. Even from beyond the grave, he's still rising up and coming between us. That's a nice one, then. I never saw this one
coming. Tell me you didn't want him dead.
Why? It sounds like you've already made up your
just
mind.
Just tell me and I'll believe you.
Yes. I wanted him dead. What is it you want from me?
To show this is having some sort of effect on you.
Why? Why does it matter what I feel? Look, you're the one grieving for him and I'm trying to be here for you, but you can't keep turning this around on me. I'm not going to cry for him.
He was your dad as well.
He meant different things to us. You saw your father being carried out of here. I saw a corpse being removed in a metal coffin.
He really means that little to you. He was part of our lives.
Right from the start of this, I never understood how you could forgive him that easily. How you could just forget everything that happened.
I loved him. I killed him with my own hands. I hit him. I buried him. I walked all over his grave. Here.
Right. Let's get this over and done with, shall we?
Is that it? Let's get this over and done with?
I'm sorry, I didn't mean to lie.
This is your father's funeral.
He's your father.
That's the only reason you're going through today, is it? For me.
What do you want me to say?
Well, I want you to say that there's a tiny bit of you that's feeling sorry right now.
For him?
For everything that went wrong. For the fact that he's lying in that box and you're feeling like this
about
him.
And what good's that
gonna do? At least then you'll be showing some feelings.
Shall I? Yeah, part of it's about being there for you and supporting you.
And the other part?
This is all about a dad you loved and lost, right? Who loved and lost you.
Yeah.
Well, at least that means there was love there in the first place.
You and him were always going to be complicated. You knew that.
That man is everything that's screwed up and twisted in my life, and that's why I'm going to this funeral, to see all that go to hell.
Oh, and I'm supposed to stand next to you, am I? Knowing all that's going through your head, all that hate, all that anger.
I'm going. You can't ask me for anything else.
I'm grieving here. I'm trying to say goodbye and you're practically going to be letting off fireworks.
It's the best I can do.
Yeah, well, it's not good enough.
Billy says you haven't got it in you. And I'd never really thought about it before. I just thought that Den pushed you like he pushed everyone and you cracked. But Billy's right, isn't he? You haven't got anything like that in you. You never had.
That's amazing. You've just told me that I'm not a murderer, and you actually sound disappointed.
Oh. So is this what this is all about? Why you went along with everything I said? You just didn't want to disappoint me.
Well, I should be used to that by now, don't you think?
You don't disappoint me, Sam. You never have.
What, compared to Phil and Grant?
You're different to them, that's all.
Weaker, you mean, don't you? And more feeble. A lot more feeble.
Different.
You know, when I saw your face when I walked in that door the last time, it's your expression. I couldn't work it out at first because I don't think I'd ever seen it before. It was like for the first time in my life, I'd done something right.
I'd never call what happened to Den Watts right.
Okay, but something that the boys would do. Something that wasn't right, but something that wasn't all that wrong either. Something that you would talk about with your friends in the pub over a drink and you'd say, look, you know, I wish it hadn't happened, of course, but goes to show, no one messes with a Mitchell, do they? And it was nice, Mum. Seeing you look at me like that, it was really nice.
I'm proud of you in a different way to the boys.
No, you're not.
And so what if you're not like them? It's no one's fault.
You know, you get a lot of time to do a lot of thinking when you're in a place like this.
Yeah. You get a lot of time to make up a lot of stories and all, don't you? One minute you give the impression that you did kill Den. Next minute you're not saying.
And now I'm wondering whether me being like this, being different to the boys, and you do mean weaker, Mum, you do mean more feeble, whether deep down, that actually suited you. So I know what I'm like. I always have, but who made me like that? Who made sure of it?
I thought you'd show up today. So you got nothing to say?
Everyone deals with these things in their own way, Sharon.
When you've done that, have you dealt with it?
Have you?
Yeah. It was weird. Standing by Dad's grave, it was like I suddenly let go. All those years of loving him and hating him. And all the time I was wishing.
Well, that I felt the same. I don't have the same history as you do with Den, Sharon. I don't have the same memories.
But he was your dad.
Why does everyone keep saying that?
Because it's true.
Not in the same way it was for you.
Him to be.
I gave up on that a long time ago. It's true, I did. I mean, you may have said goodbye to him today, I did it a long, long time ago.
Okay, so what would it have cost? Well, that's true. What would it have cost for you to be there today? Knowing how I was feeling, what I was going through.
How could I be there? You told me.
knows how I'm feeling, who understands what I'm going through, but you, you'd rather keep on hating the dead than reaching out for the living. And what sort of man does that make you?
Look, it's over with now. Yeah, the funeral, it's done and dusted. Can't we just put it behind us?
I'll tell you what kind of man that makes you, shall I? That makes you dad. The kind of man who runs away when something happens, who doesn't deal with you, who just grabs hold of any excuse and gets out. And Dad kept running for the best part of 20 years. How long's it gonna be for
you? I'm not running away. I'm dealing with it in my own way. Like you are in yours. I'm dealing with it different, that's all.
Daughter, Sharon.